Even as I was a student at Columbia University, I had a lot of opportunity to actually work part-time. I was working for the WPIX television station and for the New York State Education Department. I made a series of programs called World Neighbors, which exposed me to all cultures of the world. Then it occurred to me that all this knowledge should be useful to my country. I was provoked by Western views of India and Indian civilization, which projected India as a country of snake charmers and rope tricks, and did not give any recognition to the great culture and values that India had. And I had always had this interest of using media for social change.
Knowledge explodes. It changes your very perception of India. The single most ambitious and most expensive non-fiction film ever produced here. The first Indian film to be distributed under the internationally renowned banner of Warner Brothers. Indus Valley to Indira Gandhi. An exciting creation of a decade of passionate research and 2 years of painstaking filming in over 120 locations.
Until that point in time, a documentary meant the compulsory screening of 20 minutes before a feature film in the cinema houses. Those 20 minutes which is given to the films division is the time when people can go out for a smoke or go and have a cool drink and come back to the cinema hall. So I said, I'm going to take this challenge, release a feature-length documentary and see how people react. It was not sponsored by anybody, and it had no financial backing from either government or any large corporate enterprise. I had kind of burnt my boats to make this film. The commercial distributors were not interested in it. There was no way of distributing a four-hour-long documentary. Warner Brothers came to my rescue. Suddenly, from a total failure, it became a total success.
Attempts what no filmmaker, Indian or foreign, has so far attempted. Bold in conception and execution, credible and of absorbing interest, there is not a dull moment. The director unearths layer after layer the soul of India, the spirit that lies beneath the sediment, a moving, powerful and thorough piece of work, an objective and painstaking odyssey.
Knowledge explodes. It changes your perception of India.
If you remain uncompromising in terms of your ideals, whatever your ideal is, you are likely to succeed. Receiving an award is a recognition, it's not an achievement. So I'm very happy that I received these awards, but I wouldn't consider awards as achievements. Making what you want to do is achievement. Satisfaction comes from the fact that we have not compromised in life. If you reach a total level of satisfaction, then you become stagnant. So it is important that you remain a little bit unsatisfied so that you are able to do more things in future. And that is the level of satisfaction that I have.
And I have never accepted making a single film in which I did not believe.
And I have made films which I have dreamt about.